Hey guys, Jitten here, and welcome back to another episode of Doki Doki Literature Club Plus. We are back here in the lovely Metaverse computer. Apparently we have some new pictures unlocked. We looked at these, didn't we? We looked at all these things. Kim, why did you not remember that we looked at all these last time? This is my wallpaper. I got excited that there were new secrets. Apparently not. So, at the end of the last episode, we made it to this lovely screen, as you can see, because it's our wallpaper, and we hit a little bit of a wall with the files. It was 1, 2, 3. We opened this one. I don't remember what time it was now, so I can't reopen it. But it's got to do something with the music. It listed like a bunch of music names for like song ideas. And I figured it would be track 6, which is Poem Panic. But I don't think it is. So I think we're going to have to maybe unlock some more. Maybe there will be some that show up earlier that push, like change these numbers around or something. So that's the plan. I think we're going to hop back into things. Talk with Monica for a little bit. And then we'll probably move on. What just happened? I just had an awful dream. I was hoping those would stop now. It's just the two of us. I guess I was wishful thinking. Jaden, I don't know if you have any idea, but you know about me causing that. Could you try to do something about it? Whenever it happens, I feel like I've been killed or something. It's really a horrible feeling. If you can figure out what's causing that, I'll love you forever. Now, where was I? So apparently, it's not very, very good for Monica. If we turn off the game. So, whoopsies. I'm not really a fan of cold weather, are you? You said this already, Monica. Oh, skipping doesn't work. Okay. Are you trying to fast forward? Oh, no, I'm so sorry. I'm not boring you, am I? Oh, gosh. Well, there's nothing to fast forward to, Jaden. It's just the two of us, after all. But aside from that, time doesn't really exist anymore, so it's not going to work. Here, I'll go ahead and turn it off for you. There we go. You'll be a sweetheart and listen from now on, right? Thanks. Now, where was I? Sorry, you just said that dialogue before, so I was gonna get to new dialogue. Oh my gosh, are you stuck in an infinite loop of cold weather? Fingers getting numb. Yeah, it is cold in here. Do you know that? Do you know too much? It is cold in my room. I don't know if I like that, Monica. It does make for good cuddle weather, though. I agree. Okay, I think we've escaped the it's cold. It's too cold loop. I think we'll listen to another piece or two of dialogue. Why is my mouse moving? Why is my mouse moving? I don't like that. My mouse is not supposed to move like that. Monica? Can we not do whatever you're doing to my mouse, please? You know what's kind of creepy? The mouse moving. The mouse moving. Even though I deleted everyone else's files, I can still kind of feel them. It's like all their lines are still lingering in the air, whispering in the back of my head. Imagine if after someone you knew died, you started hearing their voice in your head. Maybe I just wasn't thorough enough, but I'm too afraid to delete anything else because I might really break things. Like, if I mess with any files relevant to me, I might accidentally delete myself, and that would ruin everything, wouldn't it? Hint, hint, wink, wink. I don't know what it's like on your end, but we should avoid something like that at all costs. I believe in you, Jaden. See, I feel bad. I don't want to delete her. Like, I feel for Monica. I understand, like, her motives and everything. She's not a horrible person. She just went about everything in a horrible way and doesn't really care for the feelings of the other girls because to her, they're not real. Because her epiphany kind of, like, upset her entire world. So, it's not, like, her fault. She's just kind of sad, alone, and scared. I really like the sound of rain. Not so much getting my clothes and hair wet, though, but A nice quiet day at home with the sound of rainfall outside my window. It's one of the most calming experiences for me. Yeah. Sometimes I imagine you holding me while we listen to the sound of the rain outside. That's not too cheesy or anything, is it? Would you ever do that for me, Jaden? Oh yeah, absolutely. That sounds lovely. It sounds just perfect, Monica. What I'm excited to see is I'm excited to see in the side stories more Monica art, because this is really the only like big like high definition outside of like the regular character art that we get of Monica. So I'm excited to see the side story art. Jaden, have you ever wondered what it feels like to die? It's something I used to think about pretty often, but recently I think I've actually learned what it feels like. I don't really understand it, but whenever you quit the game, it feels like I'm instantly put to sleep, left with nothing but my thoughts. But after a few seconds, my thoughts start to fill with incoherent, jumbled patterns. I see static and rapid flashes of color while hearing all kinds of weird screaming noises. At that point, I can't even form my own thoughts anymore. I'm just endlessly hammered by the flashing and the screaming, unable to move or even think. Pretty sure in that moment I don't really exist, but for some reason I can remember it anyway. After some immeasurable amount of time, it stops in an instant and I'm back in my own mind, and you're here with me. I've no idea what it means for the game to quit or why that stuff happens to me, and also don't know how you always come back and put everything back to normal. But if you do me a favor and do that to me as little as possible, that'd be really great. It's just really not very pleasant to be all trapped in that screaming void, but in the end, you always fix me, and it makes me feel like you really do care about me. So I have to thank you for that. It makes me feel even closer to you when you're here with me. Makes it all the more sad that I'm probably gonna delete you, Monica, because that's really the only option. We're kinda at a standstill here. I got a YouTube channel to run and a series to make, and I want to experience the side stories and figure out all the lore and do all this extra stuff. And, well, you've kind of put me in a position where I can't experience the rest of anything until I delete you out of existence. So, let's end this conversation, I guess. You got any other big brain revelations or heartfelt discussions to have? I've always hated how hard it is to make friends. Well, I guess not the making friends part, but more like the meeting new people. I mean, they're like dating apps and stuff, right? But that's not the kind of thing I'm talking about. If you think about it, most of the friends you make are people you just met by chance. Like you had a class together, or you met them through another friend, or maybe they were just wearing a shirt with your favorite band on it and you decided to talk to them. Things like that. Isn't that kind of inefficient? Feels like you're just picking at complete random. If you get lucky, you make a new friend. And comparing that to the hundreds of strangers we walk by every single day, you could be sitting right next to someone compatible enough to be your best friend for life, but you'll never know. Once you get up and go on with your day, that opportunity is gone forever. Isn't that just depressing? We live in an age where technology connects us with the world, no matter where we are. I really think we should be taking advantage of that to improve our everyday social life, but who knows how long it'll take like for something like that to successfully take off. I actually just thought it would happen by now. Well, at least I already met the best person in the whole world. Even if it was by chance. I guess I just got really lucky, huh? And that makes it even sadder what I have to do to you, Monica. Also, I just realized that I have to wait for her next dialogue in order to leave. Monica. Gosh darn it, Monica. Did you have to hide the text box from me? I was going to use that. Mean, technically, she could just trap me here forever by removing the text box. Do you like horror? I remember when we talked about it a little bit when you first joined the club. I can enjoy horror novels, but not really horror movies. The problem I have with horror movies is most of them just rely on easy tactics, like dark lighting and scary-looking monsters and jump scares and things like that. It's not fun or inspiring to get scared by stuff that just takes advantage of human instinct. But with novels, it's a little different. The story and the writing need to be descriptive enough to put together a genuinely disturbing thought into the reader's head. It really needs to etch them deeply in the story and characters and just mess with your mind. my opinion, there's nothing more creepy than things just being slightly off. Things are slightly off. That's for sure. We unlocked something new? Did we? Oh, we did. In Act 3, press the skip button while Monica's talking. Wow, look at this cute sketch of Monica. This is adorable. I like it. I like it a lot. I want that to be my wallpaper. Ah, it's so bright. Maybe that wasn't the best idea. Oh gosh, help me. You know, let's just make something cute and wholesome like this our wallpaper for now. That is still bright for this dark room. And with that, we shall go to the files, go to the characters, and the delete button is right there underneath my webcam. Move that out of the way, and I'm gonna click it. Are you sure you want to delete this file? Just like that, just gone. We did it. You're back. I'm sorry, Monica. This has to be done for the good of the Literature Club. What's happening? Jaden, what's happening to me? It hurts. It hurts so much. Help me, Jaden. Please, hurry and help me. Monica does not exist. Help me. This makes me sad. This makes me sad. Monica does not exist. Monica does not exist. Did you do this to me, Jaden? Did you? Did you delete me? I'm sorry, Monica. How could you? How could you do this to me? You were all I had left. I sacrificed everything for us to be together. Everything. I loved you so much, Jaden. I trusted you. You just want to torture me? Watch me suffer? Were you only pretending to be kind just to hurt me even more? I never thought anyone could be as horrible as you are. You win, okay? You win. You killed everyone. I hope you're happy. There's nothing left now. You can stop playing. Go find some other people to torture. I got an achievement for ruining everything. How lovely. Jaden, you completely, truly make me sick. Goodbye. I'm so sad. I'm sorry, Monica. Did what had to be done for the good of the club. I still love you. I can't help it. What's wrong with me? How horrible am I for you to hate me this much? All my friends, I did so many awful things. These selfish and disgusting things. I shouldn't have done any of this. I'm just messing up a world I don't even belong in. A world that you wanted to be a part of. I ruined it. I've ruined everything. Maybe that's why you deleted me. Because I destroyed everything you wanted. How could I do that to someone I love? That's not love. That's... poor Monica. Poor Monica. I've made up my mind. Jaden, I know I said I deleted everyone else, but it's kind of an exaggeration. I couldn't find it myself to do it. Even though I knew they weren't real, they were still my friends, and I loved them all. I love the Literature Club. I really did love the Literature Club. That's why I'm gonna do this. I know it's the only way for everyone to be happy. And if I really love you, then... goodbye, Monica. Hey guys, welcome back to Doki Doki Literature Club. The game where you try to date three girls and go to a literature club. That's all it is. There definitely wasn't supposed to be anything else. I don't know what you're talking about. It's an ordinary school day like any other. As usual, I'm surrounded by couples and friend groups walking to school together. I always tell myself it's about time I met some girls or something like that. Hey, Jaden! Oh, there's already one girl. That girl is Sayori, my neighbor and good friend since we were children. We used to walk to school together every day, and recently we picked up that habit once again. Jaden, are you proud of me? For what? You know, for waking up on time. Well, you've been doing that for a while now. Uh-huh. But you never even said anything about it. Even though we walk to school together every day. Well, yeah, I always thought it was implied. It's embarrassing to say it out loud. Come on, please. It's good motivation. Fine, fine. I'm proud of you, Sayori. We cross the street together and make our way to school. As we draw near, the streets become increasingly speckled with other students making their daily commute. By the way, Jaden, have you decided on a club to join yet? A club? I told you already, I'm really not... I start to say what I always do, that I'm not interested in joining any clubs, but something tells me Sayori would take more offense to that now. After all, how can I tell her that clubs are a waste of time when she's starting a club of her very own? Actually, yeah, I think I've decided on a club. Really? Which one? Tell me. I think I'll keep it a surprise. Ooh, you meanie. Be patient, you'll find out soon enough. I used to ask myself why I let myself get lectured by such a carefree girl, but I started to realize, in a way, I envy her. When Sayori puts her mind to something, she can accomplish great things, so I feel like I should do something special for her. I forgot how, like, wholesome sending was. The school day is as ordinary as ever, and it's over before I know it. So I pack up my things, and I stand up, gathering my motivation. Let's see. I recall the room number of the club from a flyer I saw. I walk across the school and upstairs, a section of the school I rarely visit. Before long, I find the room. I timidly open the door in front of me. Hello? Jaden? What are you doing here? Well, I just... Eh? I glance around the room. Huh. So you're the Jaden Sayori's always talking about. Thank you for stopping by. It's a pleasure to meet you, Jaden. We're at the Literature Club. I hope you enjoy your visit. Come on, Yuri. You don't need to be so formal. He's gonna think we're really strict or something. Sorry, Natsuki. The tall one, whose name is apparently Yuri, seems to be quite shy compared to the others. In comparison, the girl named Natsuki, despite her size, seems like the assertive one. Well, it's nice to meet both of you. I look forward to working with you. Working? Jade, don't tell me. You're... That's right. The club I've decided to join is yours, Sayori. The Literature Club. Sayori's eyes light up.
No way.
No way! Ah! Sayori wraps her arms around me, jumping up and down. Hey! Well, if Sayori is this happy, then I'm sure it won't be so bad to have you around.
Not to mention there's four of us now. That means we can become an officially recognized club.
I don't know what to say. We have to celebrate.
What an appropriate day for that, isn't it?
Yeah. After all, Natsuki decided to... Hey, don't ruin the surprise. Sorry. Everyone sit down at the table, okay?
How about I make some tea as well?
The girl is at a few desks arranged to form a table. Natsuki and Yuri walk over to the corner of the room where Natsuki grabs a wrapped tray and Yuri opens the closet. Still feeling awkward, I take a seat next to Sayori. Natsuki proudly marches back to the table, tray in hand. Okay, are you ready? Ta-da! Natsuki lifts the foil off the tray to reveal a dozen white, fluffy cupcakes, decorated to look like little cats. The whiskers are drawn with icing, and little pieces of chocolate were used to make the ears. So cute! Wow, those look amazing. Well, you know, just hurry and take one. Sayori grabs one first and I follow. It's delicious! Sayori talks with her mouth full and has already managed to get icing on her face. I turn the cupcake around in my fingers, looking for the best angle to take a bite. Natsuki is quiet. I can't help but notice her sneaking glances in my direction.
she waiting for me to take a bite? I finally bite down. The icing is sweet and full of flavor. I wonder if she made it herself. This is really good. Thank you, Natsuki. Of course it is. I'm a pro, after all. There's no need to thank me or anything. As Natsuki struggles to accept the compliment, Yuri returns to the table carrying a tea set. She carefully places a teacup in front of each one of us before setting down the teapot next to the cupcake tray. You keep a whole tea set in the classroom? Don't worry, the teacher gave us permission. After all, doesn't a hot cup of tea help you enjoy a good book? I guess. Already trying to impress our new member, Yuri? That's not... Insulted, Yuri looks away. I meant that, you know. I believe you. Well, tea and reading might not be a pastime for me, but I at least enjoy tea. I'm glad. Yuri faintly smiles to herself in relief. So, Jaden, what kind of things do you like to read? Well, considering how little I've read over these past few years, I don't really have a good way of answering that. Manga, I mutter quietly to myself, half joking. Natsuki's head suddenly perks up. Looks like she wants to say something, but she keeps quiet. Not much of a reader, I guess. Well, that can change. What am I saying? I spoke without thinking after seeing Yuri's sad smile. Anyway, what about you, Yuri? Well, let's see. Yuri traces the rim of her teacup with her finger. My favorites are usually novels that build deep and complex fantasy worlds. The level of creativity and craftsmanship behind them is amazing to me. And telling a good story in such a foreign world is equally impressive. Yuri goes on, clearly passionate about reading. She seemed so reserved and timid the moment I walked in, but it's obvious by the way her eyes light up that she finds comfort in the world of books, not people. But, you know, I like a lot of things. Don't feel intimidated if you don't read much, okay? I'm certain we can find something we have in common. Hey, Yuri? Huh? Well, about the, you know, the first thing he said? Manga? That's right. Natsuki tends to read manga in the club room. Don't just say it. For some reason, Natsuki seems embarrassed about it. Besides, manga is literature too, you know? So, if Jaden wants to read some of my manga, then don't try to stop him or anything. Natsuki, I wouldn't do such a thing. However, it could also be nice for us to diversify ourselves a little. He can take this opportunity to try something new as well. Wouldn't you agree, Jaden? Maybe. Sensing the tension, Sayori jumps in. Maybe we can all try something new. I think it could be fun. And we'll all get to know each other a little bit better, too. I mean, that's the kind of thing literature clubs do, right? I don't disagree or anything. Yeah, you're right as usual, President. Guess it means I should try picking up a novel or something, huh? Well, that would make two of us. I wouldn't mind doing it if I'm not the only one. Then, as for Yuri... I have to read manga? Jeez, you were the one who suggested we diversify. You should be a little more open-minded. It's kind of hurtful. Hurtful? I didn't realize. With a guilty expression, Yuri thinks to herself. I'm sorry for disrespecting your interests, Natsuki. If you're into it, then I'm sure it's a worthy form of literature. Are you just saying that? No, I've realized my error. So, if you're willing to consider starting a novel, then... I'll offer my gratitude by finding a manga to read as well. Ah, it's so cute. It's so cute. Man, this game is such a treat. Really? I mean, it makes me happy you do that for me, Yuri. You can trust me to find something you'll really like, okay? And same here. Perhaps I'll visit this bookstore after the club meeting. Just you? Would you like to come along with me? If you don't mind. It's adorable. Oh, it's so cute. Oh my gosh, I forgot about all this. Oh, yay. Not at all. I always go alone, so. Yeah, me too. I agree, Sayori. This is so cute. Sayori, shut up. No, don't shut up. This is adorable. I love it. I'll show you some manga there too, okay? Yes, I look forward to it. Natsuki and Yuri start to clean up the food. I guess the meeting's over, huh? Looks like it. It's nice to see everyone getting along, isn't it? I think everyone likes you too, Jaden. You think so? Everyone always seems to get along a little better when around you, Sayori. Aw, Jaden, don't say something like that. It's embarrassing. Well, whatever. I was surprised when you told me you were starting a club, but I think you're pulling it off just fine. We're going to make it the best club ever. Now that you joined, every day is going to be so much fun. Hey, Jaden? I really want to thank you. I mean, I'm really happy you joined the club and everything. But the truth is, I already knew you were going to. There's actually something else. I wanted to thank you for getting rid of Monica.
Oh, chills.
The big reveal. That's right. I know everything that she did. Maybe it's because I'm the president now. But I really know everything, Jaden. I know how hard you tried to make everyone happy. And about all the awful things Monica did to make everyone really sad. But none of that matters anymore. It's just us now. And you make me the happiest girl in the whole world. I can't wait to spend every day like this with you forever and ever. Forever. No. Hmm? What's happening? I won't let you hurt him. Who? It hurts. Ah! I'm sorry. I was wrong. There is no happiness here after all. Goodbye, Sayori. Goodbye, Jaden. Goodbye, Literature Club. Ah, and that is the curse of the Literature Club. There it is.
Can you hear me? Hi, it's me. So you know how I've been like practicing piano and stuff?
Get subtitles. And
not really any good at it yet, like at all. But I wrote you a song, and I was kind of hoping that I could show it to you because I worked really, really hard on it. So yeah.
Oh, yay! We did it, guys.
Every day, I imagine a future where I can be with you.
Oh, I haven't listened to the song in forever. Oh, I love it.
In my hand is a pen that will write a poem of me and you. The ink flows down into a dark puddle.
I'm not gonna say.
Just move your hand.
I thought about it. Almost.
Right away into his heart. But in this world of infinite choices,
we'll just enjoy this.
What will it take just to find that special day? What will it take just to find that special day?
Doki Doki Literature Club. In all of its glory. Yeah, the this is new. Yeah, the credits are different. It's still the same pictures. Can show us what we missed. Look at all the people that helped. Ah, look at this. The credits are so full. I love it. This makes me really happy. There's all the pictures we missed. Dude, everything's getting deleted. We're going back. We'll get everything. Don't you guys worry. It's on the list of things to do. We're not done with this game yet. Like I said, we got all the side stories, but in order to get all the side stories, we got to do all these stories first. I know, it's taken a while to get to all the new stuff. I know, but I just wanted to enjoy revisiting the game, you know? I may be weeks and weeks behind everybody else, but I'm taking it at my own pace and just enjoying replaying the game again. Down into a dark puddle.
Gosh, this song is so good. Remove game screens, just deleting it all. It's all going away. Remove the game itself. The GUI is gone. Special thanks to Monica and Jade. Aw, look at that. There goes the scripts and the menu. Made with love by Team Salvato. What a good game. And Serenity Forge, thank you for helping bring the physical edition and this new Doki Doki Plus to life. I got an achievement. Thank you. This is my final goodbye to the Literature Club. I finally understand. The Literature Club is a place where no happiness can be found. To the very end, it continued to expose innocent minds to a horrific reality, a reality that our world is not designed to comprehend. I can't let any of my friends undergo that same hellish epiphany. For the time it lasted, I want to thank you for making all of my dreams come true, for being a friend to all of my club members. And most of all, thank you for being a part of my Literature Club. With everlasting love, Monica. Error! Everything is missing or corrupt. Please run reset to repair and reset the virtual machine. Ah, we could listen to all the songs now. Poem Panic is still number 6. So there's got to be something else to do with those. What do we get? I want to see the new pictures. We got Monica's final message. We get any other secrets or anything? We gotta get a sketch for beating the game, right? No? Nothing else? That's it? Aw, man. I want more secrets. Give me more sketches and secrets and backgrounds and everything. I want it all. Oh, don't worry. We're gonna get it all. Do we have any mail? Still no mail, huh? Have we got anything else in the files? Everybody's back but Monica. Poem words. Saves all these things. I think we can go ahead and use the reset. I wonder what happens if I delete the reset. That's probably a bad idea. But this I'm sure hasn't changed. Yeah, I think we can go ahead and do the reset then. Because I haven't been able to think of anything else specifically to do. Yay. I still like Candy Hearts. Candy Hearts is a really good new song. I like it a lot. I like to put that on while we do things. I like this background a lot too. This is a good wallpaper. But yeah, did we unlock any? We didn't unlock any side stories yet, still. If we try to open Doki Doki, what happens? It just takes you to this. Cool. Okay. Then it is time. Pop the old reset. Reset this virtual machine, Doki Doki Literature Club. All modified entities, environments, and data will be reverted to their original state. I think that's what we gotta do, right? Connecting, stopping, environment. Oh, there's going to be a secret in here, isn't there? Restoring entities. I feel like there's going to be something secret hidden in here. Monitor kernel access. So that's Monica. She has special access permissions. The other three have none. Okay, there's definitely secrets in there. I'll have to look back on that. Wow, we start all the way over with the original thing. Yes, contains spoilers. I'm curious. I want to read this now that we've beaten the game. It's a horror game. Do not take this lightly. It may not be suitable if you are affected by any of the following themes. Depression, suicide, self-harm, abuse. These themes are not merely suggestions, but are often portrayed as realistically as possible and may disturb you as if they were real. Furthermore, the above list is not 100% exhaustive. If you would like to be warned when potentially sensitive content is about to occur. Oh, detailed content warnings can be enabled in the settings. That is really cool. Thank you for your consideration and for staying safe. I agree. That's really good. I like that. I'm glad that that's in the game and that's an option. Good accessibility, Dan Salvato. You genius of a man. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. We got no saves. We got nothing here. If we exit, return to the desktop. Still got no mail. Everything is back to how it was. My pictures are still here. Okay. This is all I care about. As long as this all stays here when we do a reset. I'm surprised we only got one promo image. No new songs. Still no mail. I wonder how we get mail to start showing up. That's interesting. That is very, very interesting. Okay. All right. Well, a little bit shorter of an episode compared to the usual Doki Doki episodes, but I think this is probably a good place to wrap it up. Next episode, we will zoom our way through the other options, get everybody's things, and get the good ending and all that fun stuff. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. If you did enjoy, please consider leaving a like or subscribing if you are not already. I appreciate all the support on the Doki Doki videos. I love this game. It's a lot of fun to dive into all the secrets that it has to offer and just for what else this game is hiding beneath the surface. So we'll definitely be back. We'll be playing some more. We'll get to the side stories soon. We've got like probably an episode for Natsuki and an episode for Sayori. Maybe I might be able to combine them depending on how fast we read through some things. And then we'll be on to the side stories. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Later!